Do you know that you could be bullish and bearish at the same time on the same coin on the same chart? Today we're gonna talk about it, discussing the big daddy, the biggest of them all, Bitcoin. And in these red days, in these hard days, I'm gonna find some light that you might need as my fellow crypto investor. So please open your mind and follow me to the charts. Thank you for still being a part of this video. I hope you won't leave disappointed. BTC versus USD. Today we are talking on the daily chart what is happening with the price. And yes, we know what is happening. In the short term, we had a pretty nasty pullback. Many hopes and many dreams were shattered with this red candle. In my case, black candle. But you know, something very bad looking. But always ask yourself, are things so bad? As it is the sentiment of now, extreme fear. Investors are desperate at these moments, and you know how they say, you should buy something when the blood is running on the streets. And what a better chance that right now, not a financial advisor. Now let's talk about facts, because there is two sides of every coin. Well, number one, when we talk factually, you must take into account that Bitcoin is bearish. This is 34 exponential moving average, and it is the first and the most significant signal, let's say, that the price is bearish. We are well below that exponential moving average that is taking into account the last, let's say, month of price action. And you can see that it made us resistance at this point and over here. And when we were above it, like in this area, the price of Bitcoin was bullish. So take into account, factually, we can't change sides. The price is bearish and things are not looking that great. 34 exponential moving average is currently standing at $48,981. So we are just below 49,000. And if in the next few days you don't see Bitcoin climbing over that $49,000, keep in mind, simplistically, we are bearish. Just based on these facts, you could see more downside pressure. And you can even see some kind of rebound to retest that area when we touch that 34 and then make another move to the downside. Possibilities even to the lower regions of $40,000. Now, this is what the facts are telling us. Bitcoin is on the daily chart bearish. But let's remove those indicators and those facts. Let's take into account our viewing on the charts. In this case, my dinosaur eyes. Clean slate. First of all, and first indication why I will not take any narrative that this is a bear market or something like that, is the fact that we still haven't broken this level, and that is $40,000. This line is $40,588, but that is not important for simplicity. Just think about $40,000. So if we don't break 40K, we are not bearish. Those are just pure facts based on the higher lows and higher highs. This low, although it's looking pretty bad, it's standing at 43,000, and that is well above 40. So we got, let's say, more wiggle room. A line number two that you certainly don't need to underestimate is this one. This is our down sloping line of resistance. You can see that it's showing a pretty clear downtrend, or let's say it was until this point at the end of last year when we climbed above it. So I want to tell you this, was our first impulsive move to the downside that has ended right here. We are now in that second move, and the second move, or the third or the fourth, as long as you go, is always, well, let's say, weaker. This was a strong downtrend. We are now entering the second phase, which is not that strong. Now check out one more thing. You can see that from that point, we made several touches indicating that this is a valid resistance. And after that break, here, we first touched this trend line, making it support, which is a good sign. But unfortunately, we did that second time, right now. Yesterday, or a few days ago after you watched this video, I don't know, but you know what I'm talking about. This was a resistance, now this is a support. So this is not the super bad situation. As long as we are hovering above this trend line, in my opinion, we're good. Now, that is not to say that there is not a possibility that we do this one more time. For example, something like this, and retest that trend line one more time. Now, although I don't think that will be the case, it will be probable, and it still wouldn't crush our bullish macro targets. So as long as we are living above this trend line, I think that the slow and gradual recovery of the price at Bitcoin has already started. But now is the time to show you how you can use your imagination. And this is the part where I said that there are always two sides of a coin, factual and that discretional, when you as an investor had to see something that could be evolving. I'm seeing this line of resistance now in play. But as a support, check this out. If we use this highest point of the previous run to the upside and draw it all the way, for example, to these levels, what did we just get? Is it possible that we are forming a falling wedge, a bullish reversal pattern? I mean, why not? Resistance, resistance, support, support. And not to mention this previous and very significant point of resistance. Is it surreal to expect that the price could do something like this? I don't think so. I think this is a realistic scenario and the one that could be playing out in the next couple of weeks. Now, of course, there are multiple scenarios if we get out of this falling wedge, which you should tell me in the comments, do you think that it even exists? That we could go sideways, for example, to numb your emotions and your feelings. Not higher, but sideways. You know, volatility to the lowest levels. And then make that fantastic move to the upside. Those are all possibilities that I'm seeing on the charts right now. Factually, we are bearish, but some signs of recovery, as you just saw, are on the charts. I didn't make them up, I just drew the lines from the point A to the point B. And just to mention something, now that we are talking about Bitcoin, what do you expect? Let me know in the comments for Bitcoin in 2022. I will let you know my opinion, and that is, many of you are stating $100,000. Now, do I think that Bitcoin will go to 100,000 in this year, 2022? In my opinion, more realistic target is $200,000. And yeah, I know, you think that I'm a cuckoo for cocoa, or whatever is that saying, a nutcase. But I believe that when we go bullish, we will surpass 100,000 with ease, because just ask yourself, why would something surpass 60,000 or what is now 70,000 at our highest point and just then go to $100,000? It doesn't make any sense if we go bullish. And I'm talking about real bull, which I am expecting. I think about far higher targets than the 100,000. I mean, why not expect at least 2x from the previous highs, or even 3? Who knows? Maybe I'm super bullish, maybe I'm all full of hopium and crap. But in any case, thank you for being still here and to making until the end of this video. Now, I would advise you that you watch this video in which we made a celebration of 5,000 subscribers. It was a long time ago, half a year ago. But if you're into Bitcoin, watch that one, because in there I gave you one interesting and fascinating chart. Now click away.